When we treat patients for MS, we aim to personalize the therapy, meaning identify which specific drug would be best for a patient, or to put another way, which patient their disease will respond best to a specific drug. Fortunately, at this point, we don't have an effective way to say this patient will respond to this drug and that patient will respond to another drug. But what we do have is ways to stratify the risk of complications, and to aim patients towards one drug or another to minimize risk. So for example, with the S1P modulators, we know that cardiac rhythm problems is a risk that we have to consider with those patients. So a patient who may have had cardiac arrhythmia in the past, we would steer away from an S1P drug and put towards another drug. Patients who have been exposed to the virus, the JC virus, which increases the risk of developing the brain infection, PML, we aim away from the drug natalizumab because we know that increases patients' risk for the brain infection. Also, patients who have a tender belly, who are easily made to have nausea or vomiting or diarrhea, we will avoid from dimethyl fumarate because we know that can upset the stomach. So right now, we can aim patients away from particular drugs because of safety concerns, but we haven't yet figured out how to aim patients towards or away from drugs based on efficacy. Along the same lines, we don't know if we should aim all patients towards the most effective drugs and then gradually escalate back over time if that very effective drug is not needed, or if we should start with a modestly effective drug and gradually escalate as needed. So do we start hard and then consider pulling back over time, or do we gradually work our way up? There's risk for each. If you start up high, you have higher risk of safety complications. If you start slowly, you may accumulate more injury from the MS before you find a drug that's effective. There are a few trials ongoing now which are going to try to answer that. Do you start with the highest intensity first, or do you escalate? And that will help guide us once we know that answer.